Prime Minister Narendra Modi to address the nation today. This would be Prime Minister's sixth address to the nation since the outbreak of the pandemic. Indian and Chinese military officials to hold third round of Corps commander-level border talks at Chushul in Ladakh. The two sides are expected to deliberate on the implementation of agreement arrived at the first round of talks. India's first successfully developed COVID-19 vaccine candidate, Covaxin, gets approval for human trials. Covaxin, developed by Bharat Biotech in collaboration with ICMR and NIV Pune, human clinical trials scheduled to start across India in July 2020. Government issues unlock two guidelines for the period between 1st to 31st July. Schools and colleges, metro rails, cinemas, gymnasiums, bars to remain shut. Domestic flights, passenger train services to be further expanded in a calibrated manner. Strict lockdown to continue in containment zones. States take measures to curb coronavirus spread. Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu extend lockdown till 31st July. Ongoing intense lockdown in Chennai and Madurai extended till 5th July. Delhi to conduct door-to-door survey in containment zones and later rest of the capital. Government bans 59 mobile apps, including TikTok, CamScanner, ShareIt, over public concerns on data security. Says banned apps are prejudicial to the sovereignty, integrity and defense of the country. Also harm the privacy of the citizens. Recovery rate of corona patients in India continues to show steady improvement, crosses 59%. Active cases in the country more than 2,15,000. Global COVID-19 cases over 1 crore 2 lakh, with more than 5,04,000 deaths. WHO chief warns that the pandemic is still speeding up. Hello, you're watching DD News and I'm Preeti presenting the bulletin. In the next half an hour, we'll get you an account of everything that's been making it to the headlines. Our top story first. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will address the nation today. The Prime Minister's office tweeted via its Twitter handle that Prime Minister will address the nation at 4 p.m. today. His address comes against the backdrop of the country entering Unlock 2 from 1st of July, for which guidelines were issued by Union Home Ministry on Monday night. Further easing the restrictions imposed due to coronavirus lockdown, this would be Prime Minister's sixth address to the nation since the outbreak of the pandemic. In his recent interaction with the chief ministers, he had urged them to think about phase two of unlocking to boost the economy hit by COVID-19 pandemic and also the nationwide lockdown. In his Mann Ki Baat program on, that is the radio program on Sunday, he had urged the people to be more vigilant in the unlock phase and take necessary precautions, stressing that not doing so will put at risk their lives and the lives of others. Raksha Mantri Rajnath Singh will talk to his American counterpart Mark Esper on telephone today. Earlier, both the sides and also both the leaders held talks on 29th May and reviewed progress on various bilateral defense cooperation arrangements and expressed their commitment to further promote the defense partnership. In today's talks, both the leaders will further discuss the bilateral defense cooperation between the two countries. According to sources, the ongoing tensions between India and China on the line of actual control in eastern Ladakh may also come up for discussion. To get us more on that, our correspondent Sudhir is joining us. Sudhir, we've given a broad outline of the issues that could be taken up between the defense ministers of US and India. Let us know more about it. We also tell our viewers that the ongoing tensions between India and China in eastern Ladakh may also come up for discussions.
देखिए, अगर दोनों डिफेंस मिनिस्टर की जो टेलीफोनिक कन्वर्सेशन है उसकी बात करें तो आज के लिए वो शेड्यूल्ड है. जो दोनों रक्षा मंत्री से पहले भी 29 मई को बातचीत हुई थी और दोनों जो रक्षा मंत्री उन्होंने जो भारत और अमेरिका के बीच जो डिफेंस टाइज हैं उनको लेके रिव्यू किया था कि आखिर किस तरीके से जो भारत और अमेरिका की जो रक्षा संबंध है वो किस तरीके से आगे बढ़ रहे हैं वो उसको डिस्कस किया गया था. इसके अलावा अगर आज की हम बात करें तो इस जो कॉपरेशन है डिफेंस कॉपरेशन है उसको लेकर कैसे आगे बढ़ा जाए, खासतौर पर अगर मेक इन इंडिया की बात करी जाए तो जो यूएस टेक्नोलॉजी है उसको लेकर मेक इन इंडिया के तहत किस तरीके से जो भारत का रक्षा निर्माण है उसको लेकर कैसे आगे बढ़ा जाए वो डिस्कस हो सकता है. इसके अलावा अगर पीछे बात करें कि जो करंट एलएसी पर जो टेंशन चल रही है, जिस तरीके से जो तनाव भारत और चीन के बीच बना हुआ है, ये भी एक मुद्दा है जो दोनों रक्षा मंत्री उनकी बातचीत में इसके भी डिस्कस होने की संभावना है.
Alright, Sudhir, there is also, we tell our viewers that there is also expectation to further strengthen the defense cooperation between the two countries, that is India and US. Tell us more about that as well.
बिल्कुल प्रीति, देखिए जिस तरीके से भारत और यूएस का जो डिफेंस जो कॉपरेशन है वो बढ़ता जा रहा है, दोनों देशों के बीच में एक स्पेशल मैकेनिज्म है 2+2 डायलॉग, जब वहाँ दोनों देशों के विदेश मंत्री और रक्षा मंत्री जो दोनों देशों का जो ओवरऑल कॉपरेशन है किस तरीके से बढ़ रहा है उसको डिस्कस करते हैं, तो ये मैकेनिज्म अपने आप में पहले से मौजूद है जिससे कि दोनों देशों के जो संबंध है वो बहुत बेहतरी की तरफ बढ़ रहे हैं. 2018 में दिल्ली में पहला 2+2 डायलॉग शुरू हुआ था, 2019 में वॉशिंगटन में जो दोनों देशों के विदेश मंत्री और रक्षा मंत्री हैं उन्होंने बातचीत की थी, तो जाहिर तौर पर अपने आप में बहुत अहम जो कॉपरेशन है वो आगे बढ़ रहा है. खास के अलावा भी प्रीति की भारत जो डिफेंस प्लेटफॉर्म पर जो रक्षा साजो सामान उपकरण है वो भी यूएसए खरीद रहा है, तो वो भी एक जो दोनों का कॉपरेशन है वो काफी आगे बढ़ता जा रहा है. आज की अगर हम बात करें, अब थोड़े दिन पहले ही रक्षा मंत्री ने पहले ही जो अपने यूएस काउंटर पार्ट है उनसे बातचीत की थी, तो आज की बातचीत की अगर हम बात करें तो ओवरऑल कॉपरेशन को लेके जो रीजनल इश्यूज हैं, वर्ल्ड अफेयर्स को इश्यूज हुए हैं वो डिस्कशन हो सकते हैं, और खासतौर पर जो जो टाइज भारत और अमेरिका को लेकर है, जो रक्षा संबंध है किस तरीके से और बेहतरी की तरफ आगे बढ़े, इन सब चीजों को लेकर डिस्कशन हो सकता है.
ऑल राइट, थैंक यू सो मच सुधीर फॉर जॉइनिंग अस विद दोस इनपुट्स. दैट वाज आवर कॉरेस्पोंडेंट सुधीर यादव टेलिंग अस मोर अबाउट द टॉक्स which Defense Minister Rajnath Singh will have with his American counterpart over telephone. We'll keep you updated. Meanwhile, let's get you more on the India-Pak military level talks, the third round of the talks. In an attempt to de-escalate tension in eastern Ladakh, Indian and Chinese military officials will hold the third round of core commander level border talks at Chushul in Ladakh today. The two sides are expected to deliberate on the implementation of an agreement arrived at the first round of the Lieutenant General level talks on 6th of June. The meet is likely to finalize modalities for disengagement of the troops from sensitive region. The Indian delegation at the talks will be headed by 14 Corps Commander Lieutenant General Harinder Singh, while the Chinese side is likely to be led by Commander of Tibet Military District. The first two meetings had taken place at Maldo on the Chinese side of the LAC. In the second round of talks on 22nd of June, the two sides arrived at a mutual consensus to disengage from all the friction points in eastern Ladakh. India's first successfully developed COVID-19 vaccine candidate, Covaxin, gets approval for human trials. Covaxin, successfully developed by Bharat Biotech in collaboration with the Indian Council of Medical Research and the National Institute of Virology, Pune. Now, according to the Health Secretary, Drug Controller General of India, that is DCGI, has granted permission to start phase 1 and 2 human clinical trials. Success or failure will depend on the results of the clinical trials. Also, human clinical trials are scheduled to start across India in July. The SARS-CoV-19 strain was isolated in National Institute of Virology, Pune, and transferred to Bharat Biotech. The indigenous inactivated vaccine developed and manufactured in Bharat Biotech's BSL-3, that is Biosafety Level 3, high containment facility located in Genome Valley in Hyderabad. And to get us more on that, Nitendra Singh is joining us. Nitendra, how important is this? India's first successfully developed COVID-19 vaccine, co-vaccine, has got the approval for human trials, and the trials will begin from July. Get us the details.
तैयार कर लिया है और इसको जो लैब में उसकी जो रिपोर्ट थे वो काफी इम्पोर्टेंट थे और सराहनीय थे और उसकी सक्सेस थे और उसकी रिपोर्ट को उन्होंने स्वास्थ्य मंत्रालय को सौंपा और ड्रग कंट्रोलर जनरल ऑफ इंडिया ने इसको देखने के बाद ह्यूमन ट्रायल के लिए फर्स्ट और सेकंड फेज के लिए परमिशन दे दी है और वो जुलाई से ह्यूमन ट्रायल शुरू होगा और इसकी अगर सफलता अच्छी रही तो फिर ये जल्दी भारत में मार्केट में वैक्सीन आ जाएगा तो निश्चित तौर पे भारत के लिहाज से बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है भारत के वैज्ञानिकों के लिहाज से बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है क्योंकि आईसीएमआर की जो एनआईवी पुणे की ब्रांच है वहां पे वायरस को आइसोलेट किया गया था उनके स्ट्रेन को और वो भारत बायोटेक को दिया गया था और भारत बायोटेक ने इस पे काम किया उनके साइंटिस्टों ने दिन रात मिलकर के एक करके के काम किया है और उसके बाद वैक्सीन को तैयार किया है और जब ये जुलाई में ह्यूमन ट्रायल फर्स्ट और सेकेंड फेज दोनों पर ट्रायल हो जाएगा और उसकी जो सक्सेस रेट देखी जाएगी अगर वो सफल रहा तो फिर जल्द ही भारत में वैक्सीन तैयार हो जाएगा।
All right, Nitendra, also this is indeed very important for the country, but at present I would want you to assess this current situation. On one hand, we have the recovery rate improving for COVID-19. At the same time, we also see that cases are rising. So what is your assessment of the situation, given the fact that 59% is what the recovery rate is at present?
देखिए जो रिकवरी रेट रेगुलर डे बाय डे बढ़ता जा रहा है 59% है इस वक्त है और सबसे बड़ी बात है कि 2 लाख से ज्यादा लोग अब तक ठीक हो चुके हैं और इसमें देखा जाए कि जो एक्टिव केस है और जो लोग हॉस्पिटल से डिस्चार्ज हो गए ठीक हो गए उनके बीच में गैप 1 लाख से ज्यादा है। इसका मतलब ये है कि जितने लोग अगर संक्रमित भी हो रहे हैं उससे ज्यादा लोग अब ठीक होकर के घर जा रहे हैं। तो आप अगर मैं दर्शकों को भी ये जरूर कहना चाहूंगा कि अगर आप सतर्क रहें, जागरूक रहें और अगर मान लिया संक्रमित होते हैं और अगर आप समय पे अपना जांच कराते हैं, ट्रीटमेंट लेते हैं तो जल्द से जल्द आप ठीक हो जाते हैं। तो प्रोटोकॉल का अगर कोई पालन करता है तो निश्चित तौर पर वो जल्द से जल्द ठीक हो जाता है। घबराने की बिल्कुल भी बात
All right, that was our correspondent Nitendra Singh telling us more about the co-vaccine, which has got DCGI's approval for human clinical trials. And he was also telling us that at present the recovery rate is 59%, which means that people have to still abide by the guidelines which have been put forth by the government in ensuring social distancing, self-isolation, and also wearing masks when they step out of their homes, and also maintaining and keeping hand hygiene. These are the important precautions which have to be taken, given the fact that the recovery rate at present is 59%, which means that recoveries are more in the country than the active cases. We'll keep you updated on that. As we tell you this, India continues to march forward in the fight against COVID-19. The steps taken by the governments are showing encouraging results as the recovery rate further has improved to 59.06%. The gap between recoveries and active cases continues to widen. Presently, 3,34,821 recoveries and 2,15,125 active cases have been reported. There is a difference of 1,19,696 cases between the number of recoveries and the active cases. The total number of cases in India rose to 5,66,840 and the death toll was 16,893. The number of labs is also increasing with each passing day. India now has 1,047 diagnostic labs dedicated to COVID-19. This includes 760 in the government sector and 287 private labs. The total number of samples tested is showing an uphill trend and has touched 83,98,362 mark. 1,70,560 samples were tested between Sunday and Monday. 11 labs have been inducted in the last 24 hours. All of these are operated by the government. Union Ministry of Home Affairs had last night issued new guidelines for Unlock 2 to open up more activities in the areas outside the containment zones. The new guidelines will come into effect from 1st of July. The process of phased reopening of the activities has been extended further. The new guidelines are based on the feedback received from states and union territories and extensive consultations held with related central ministries and departments. As stipulated in Unlock 1 order and guidelines issued on 30th of May, certain activities, that is religious places and places of worship for the public, hotels, restaurants and other hospitality services, shopping malls have already been permitted from 8th of June outside the containment zones. Detailed standard operating procedures have also been issued, and up next we'll take a look at the salient features of the new guidelines for Unlock 2. When we talk of Unlock 2, then domestic flights and passenger trains have already been allowed in a limited manner. Their operations will be further expanded in a calibrated manner. Night curfew timings are being further relaxed, and now curfew will be in force from 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. Now, these relaxations in night curfew have been given for seamless operation of industrial units in multiple shifts, movement of persons and goods on national and state highways. Shops can have more than 5 people at a time, depending upon their area. However, they have to maintain adequate physical distancing. Training institutions of the central and state government